Panda. I got broads in Atlanta. Since you thought me in the family. Credit cards and the scammers. Hitting the licks in the banner. Legacies. Hi guys. Today we are going to show you the QLA Matebook review. QLA's put together a perfectly solid tablet with options for a decent amount of processing power, storage, and memory. While the most demanding users may crave a little more from the Matebook, we think that many people will be plenty happy with what it's capable of doing. The Matebook looks and feels pretty nice, and while we did have a few misgivings about a few design decisions, the whole package comes together quite well, and that's all the more impressive for this being QLA's inaugural 2-in-1 tablet effort. But for all it does right, the Matebook does come up short in a few respects. Its trio of accessories are welcome additions to the tablet, but each manages to leave us wanting just a little more. And that the three of them combined add nearly an extra $300 to your purchase price is a serious factor to consider when deciding just how much the mobile convenience of a 2-in-1 is worth to you. Compared to something like the Surface Pro 4, the Matebook may start at a lower price point, but you're giving up a number of the useful built-in expansion options. Have to pay extra for a stylus and miss out on some of the higher-end hardware available. That makes deciding to buy the Matebook a little tricky. Do you pay more for a better equipped tablet? Or maybe less for one that's not as slick looking, and probably less powerful, but offers a more affordable alternative? In the end, the Matebook is stuck in an uncomfortable middle ground. It's good, but not stellar, and it exists in the shadow of some real 2-in-1 giants. QLA could get on the road to resolving this with some additional hardware options, like 16GB of RAM, or even better, by bundling in some of these accessories. But right now, it's difficult to recommend the Matebook over existing 2-in-1 tablets. That's it, thank you for watching.